हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय क्लास। दिस इज़ डॉक्टर रजनी गोयल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक फूड वी ईट। इन दिस टॉपिक वी विल लर्न व्हाई डू वी नीड फूड, फूड आइटम्स बेस्ड ऑन एनर्जी गिविंग दैट इज कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स एंड फैट्स, बॉडी बिल्डिंग दैट इज प्रोटीन्स एंड प्रोटेक्टिव फूड्स। प्रोटेक्टिव फूड्स मीन्स वाइटमिन्स एंड मिनरल्स। फंक्शंस ऑफ फूड कॉम्पोनेंट्स, फूड कॉम्पोनेंट्स मीन्स कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, फैट्स, प्रोटीन्स, वाइटमिन्स एंड मिनरल्स, अ बैलेंस्ड डाइट एंड हाउ टू अवॉइड वेस्टेज ऑफ फूड। नाउ द फर्स्ट थिंग विच वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज फूड। एज वी नो दैट ऑल लिविंग बींग नीड फूड टू स्टे अलाइव। नॉट ओनली ह्यूमंस बट इवन एनिमल्स नीड फूड फॉर लिविंग। फूड इज असेंशियल for both plants and animals. We feel weak if we do not eat for a few days. We cannot live without food for more than a few days. So any nutritious substance that people eat or drink in order to regulate life and growth is called food. Now I will explain you about the important point, that is why do we need food. Food give us energy to work and play. This energy we are getting from carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are just like fuel which fulfill the body's most immediate energy needs. Good nutrition is one of the keys to make us healthy and strong. We can improve our health by taking a balanced diet. So we should eat the food which contain vitamins and minerals. Food help us to grow, like proteins. Proteins help in the formation of new tissues. Along with this, vitamins and minerals are the two important nutrients that protect us from various types of diseases. After that, I will explain you about the nutrients. Nutrients are the different substances that help us to grow and stay healthy. There are five different types of nutrients, that is carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Carbohydrates and fats are energy giving foods. Proteins are known as bodybuilding foods. Both vitamins and minerals are called protective foods. These foods activate growth and resistance to various types of diseases. Now we will learn about these components of food in detail, that is carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Carbohydrates provide energy to our body. The energy which we are getting from carbohydrates help us to do work and play. There are two different types of carbohydrates, that is sugars and starch. Sugar is simple carbohydrate and starch is complex carbohydrates. The sugar which we are adding in our tea, coffee, cake, etc. is sucrose, and that sucrose which are we are getting from sugar cane. And the sugar which is present in milk is known as lactose. And another sugar, that is glucose, is the simplest of all the sugars and immediately taken into blood from the food pipe. That's why in emergency situations, doctor give glucose to the patients and it gives instant energy to the body. That means immediately it is giving energy to our body. Starch, as we have discussed, that is complex carbohydrates, and starch comes from cereals like rice, wheat, oat, etc. It is used in the formation of bread, chapati, naan, cake, idli, etc. After that, we will discuss the next component, that is fats. Fats and oils are almost similar substances, but fats are saturated one and oils are unsaturated ones. Fats are saturated, that's why they are solid at room temperature, but oils are liquid at room temperature. Fats we are getting from animal sources and oils we are getting from plant sources. Milk, butter, cream, cheese, egg, meat are the foods which are rich in fats, and oils comes from seeds of mustard, sunflower, olive, peanut, coconut, etc. No doubt fats give more energy than carbohydrates, but we should not eat fats in large quantity because they are not good for our health. Why they are not good for our health? Because the extra fat that we are getting from our food that get stored in our body, and that stored fat make us obese, or you can say fatty, and that fatness may cause diseases like diabetes and heart diseases. After that, I will discuss the next nutrient, that is proteins. Proteins help us to grow, and if there is any damage in our tissue, proteins help us to repair that tissue, and it also helps to build the muscles. That's why proteins are called bodybuilding foods. Children should take more of proteins as they are in growing stage of their life. Next is vitamins. The word vitamins comes from Latin word, that is vita. Vita means life. Vitamins and minerals both keep us free from various types of diseases. Fruits and vegetables are the rich sources of vitamins and minerals. We need vitamins and minerals in small quantities, but these are very important for us to stay healthy. After that, I will explain you about the different types of vitamins, like vitamin A, B, C, D, E, and K. Vitamin A, D, E, and K are fat soluble. They are stored in the body in fat-rich tissues and are used from time to time. Vitamin B and C are water soluble. Hence, they are not stored in the body and are lost through sweat and urine from time to time. They are to be replenished every day along with raw and fresh food. Vitamin A is fat soluble, as we have earlier discussed. Its deficiency may lead to night blindness. Night blindness means poor night vision. That's why children are told to take milk and eat up their carrots to be able to see in the dark. This is not just a myth, but a fact that vitamin A coming from milk and yellow fruits saves children from night blindness. Good or poor health is all due to presence or absence of vitamins. Vitamin B is water soluble. It is a group of 11 to 12 vitamins. That's why it is very complex. Its deficiency causes the disease, and the disease name is beriberi, and this disease is related to our nervous system. It also cause eyesore and anemia. Anemia means not enough blood in our body. Whole grains, nuts, fruits, vegetables are the richest source of vitamin B. Citrus fruits like amla, lemon, orange are the fruits which are rich in vitamin C. Vitamin C is water soluble. Chemically, it is known as ascorbic acid. And its deficiency disease called scurvy. Vitamin D is fat soluble. Milk, cheese, butter are the richest sources of vitamin D. Our body can make vitamin D with the help of sunlight. So that's why vitamin D is also known as sunshine vitamin. Sun rays react with the oils of the skin to produce vitamin D within the body in a natural way. People living in air-conditioned houses and offices are apt to be deficient in vitamin D. It helps in the utilization of calcium within the body and hence prevents softening and deformation of bones and teeth. Moreover, we can say that vitamin D is needed to make our bones and teeth strong. Vitamin E is fat soluble. Sunflower, olive oil, nuts are the examples of vitamin E. Vitamin E is necessary to prevent early aging, and it maintains freshness of the skin. The next vitamin is vitamin K. Vitamin K is again fat soluble. Green leafy vegetables like broccoli, beans, cabbage, methi are the richest sources of vitamin K. Vitamin K prevents excessive bleeding and helps in blood clotting. Blood clotting is also known as blood coagulation. That means it helps to reduce the loss of blood in our body. Now come to the topic, that is minerals. Minerals are the elements in the form of salts. They are needed for proper growth and formation of blood cells. They also helps to make our bones healthy and strong. They are important for performing very important functions of the body. Our body needs some minerals in good quantity and some in very small quantity. For example, calcium, phosphorus, they are required in good quantity for the formation of strong and healthy bones. Zinc, potassium, iodine are required in very minute amount, though it is essential for our body. After that, we will discuss the first mineral, that is calcium. Calcium is necessary for blood clotting. Blood clotting is also known as blood coagulation, as we have discussed earlier. Calcium is also important for make us strong, that is bones and teeth. Deficiency of calcium leads to soft bones, and the disease name is osteoporosis. After that, the next mineral is iron. As we know that our blood color is red, it is all due to presence of iron. Iron is important part of hemoglobin, which is present in RBC. RBC means red blood cells. Here, hemoglobin is made up of two words, that is heme and globin. Heme means iron and globin is protein part. Deficiency of iron leads to anemia. That means they have not enough blood in our body. Sodium and potassium are the minerals, or we can say electrolytes, which are needed for our body to function normally. It also helps to maintain blood volume in the body. A person can get high BP or blood pressure by consuming too much sodium and not enough potassium. Salty foods and fruits are the examples of sodium and potassium. Iodine is essential for proper bone and brain development. Deficiency of iron leads to formation of goiter. Goiter means there is swelling in our neck. It is all due to enlargement of thyroid gland. We can recover this disease from common salt, marine fish, by taking marine fish, coconut water and seafoods. Along with these five nutrients, water and roughage are also important part of our diet. One can live without food for few days, but not without water. Our body needs water for digesting food. Digesting food means breakdown of food. That means complex food break down into simpler ones. Excreting out waste, that means removal of waste product from our body, and regulates body temperature. Water keeps our skin moist and also helps in movement of muscles. Movement means that is contraction and relaxation. So we should drink 8 to 10 glasses of water every day. In case loss of water from the body is more and intake is less, it may result in dehydration. Dehydration means loss of water from our body. In such situation, patient should given ORS. ORS means oral rehydration solution. We can recover this problem by taking ORS solution. After that, we will discuss roughage. Roughage is the part of food that cannot be digested. Digestion means complex food, or you can say large food particles, break down into smaller ones, is called roughage. It is the fiber which is present in the food and help us to remove undigested food from our body. It add bulk to our food. Roughage also help in filling the stomach and thus satisfying our hunger. Hence they are termed as dietary fibers. And lack of these fibers in our food may result in constipation and hard stools. After that, we will discuss balanced diet. Balanced diet is a diet that contains all the nutrients in proper amount. All the nutrients means carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, water and roughage. All these seven nutrients, if they are present in proper amount, it is called balanced diet. We should eat this diet to keep us healthy and strong. Along with this, the most important point is we should not waste our food. There are many poor children in our country who are dying of hunger. So, follow certain rules to avoid the wastage of food. Preserve the food to avoid its spoilage. Keep dry food in airtight containers to avoid spoilage. Keep the cooked food in the refrigerator to prevent it from getting spoiled. In summers, keep fruits and vegetables in the refrigerator. It keeps them fresh. Thank you so much. I hope you will like this video. Eat healthy and stay healthy. Thank you.